So welcome to the project demonstration of forest fire detection along with location based monitoring in IoT. So the IoT platform we are here we are using ThingSpeak. So in this ThingSpeak we can get the parameters like temperature value as well as next chart is going to be the smoke whether it is detected or not, because we have already set the smoke sensitivity here only, and the next latitude longitude values, the location of the particular module where it is now. So here the system will send the IoT parameters data to ThingSpeak by using ESP32 module. So here we are using ESP32, right here we attach the ESP32 to the input and output modules. So the input modules are LM35, so for temperature sensor purpose, and MQ2 like a smoke detection sensor, and also GPS to get the latitude longitude values. So these three sensors interfaces to the ESP32 through this breadboard. So here the breadboard purpose is we need to distribute the 5 volts power supply throughout the input and output modules. So here we are using the breadboard to distribute the power supply. So the main power source for the system is through the solar panel, and the solar panel power is given as input to the rechargeable battery. So in order to charge the battery from solar panel, just disconnect here. Here we can say the T and S. So T nothing but transformer is just to charge a battery whenever the solar panel is not available, so sunlight is not available. So connect the S to the S, and here B to the B here, and now the phone is right. So now the battery will get charged from the sunlight, and if you want to charge the battery from the transformer, just place the transformer here and give the power supply to the plug, so that now the system will get charged. Right, so whenever the light is indicated, it will get fully charged. It will take 8 to 12 hours around to be fully charged. Okay, and next, this is the main switch to provide the power supply to the whole circuitry. So coming to the flow, so either transformer or solar panel, we are going to charge the battery from this charging circuit. So in the charging circuit, there will be four diodes. So the diode purpose is when we charge the battery from the transformer, because we are waiting AC supply, so in order to convert AC to DC, these diodes will rectify that, and the capacitor will rectify the pulses, and it will provide the pure DC to the battery to be charged. And the battery output is given through the switch to this regulator board. So here we are using LM317 in order to maintain the high current, because in our kit we are going to use smoke and ESP32 and GPS. These three are bit more power consumption modules. So in order to provide the high current, we are making use of LM317. The output of the LM317 is a 5 volts, because with this resistor and potentiometer we set the voltage for the 5 volts. That 5 volts is given to the breadboard. So here we are distributing the 5 volts to the sensors, GPS, ESP32 and smoke sensor. So before switching on these kits, we need to enable the hotspot in your phone. So before switching on the kits, we need to enable the hotspot. Why? Because we need to provide the internet service for the ESP32, then only from by using our network, so it will send the data to the ThingSpeak cloud platform. So that for that you need to go to the hotspot settings and change the hotspot name to Project ForeSeven90 without any space. It's very important, is without any space and without any capital letters, and then password should be 129. So we're not supposed to miss any single character, single letter. So then if you miss any character, the system will not send the data to the ThingSpeak. So check it, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, and now enable the hotspot and also data, right, and then log into the ThingSpeak. So as already it has a data of previous session, so here we can see the temperature along with the date and time, and now just switch on the circuit. So So once the system got initialized, then the system will start sending the data to the ThingSpeak continuously. Right. So if you want to clear this old data, right, we got the new data. So if you want to clear this old data, for that go to data import and exports and download and open that. So here we can see the right. So here these are the data available along with date and entry IDs and temperature, so called smoke status and latitude latitude values. So after downloading the data, now next go to channel settings and at last do only clear channel. Before doing, check properly, only do clear channel, and after that it will prompt us, and then go to private view. So there we can see the total data got erased. So now wait for the new data to be uploaded. Right. So now I'm placing the smoke here. We can see one green light is switching on the smoke sensor, so that it will send the alerting data to be uploaded to the ThingSpeak. Right. We're getting the new data of smoke is one, and also we can increase the temperature. So the data will be uploaded to the ThingSpeak for every 12 to 15 seconds. There's a minimum duration for the data to be plotting in the ThingSpeak, right? We can see the increased temperature here and also the smoke difference. Then in this manner, we can get the data of the location along with smoke as well as temperature data.